Good morning, Namaskar. Welcome to Hot Talk 63. Today's speaker is Dr. Deshbir Singh, Director, ICR, Central Institute of Temperate Horticulture, Srinagar, Jammu and Kashmir. He will be speak on diversification of temperate fruits and nuts. On the behalf of Progressive Horticulture, I Shiv Pratap welcome the speaker, Dr. Deshbir Singh, and you all to this edition of Hot Talk. Now I request Dr. Deshbir Singh to start the talk. Sir,
namaskar to all. Mm-hmm. Good morning and namaskar to all. Before going for the talk of the topic, I will introduce myself. Myself, Deshbir Singh. I belong to Kashmir. And after doing my PhD from Agra University and master degree from Punjab Agriculture University, Ludhiana, I joined as a scientist at Kerry Port Blair. I started my career from the tropical islands. I worked there for 15 years on tropical ecosystem. I worked on the major fruit crops of the islands, that is pineapple, banana, mango, and other crops. Apart from that, I extensively worked for untapped and neglected fruits and minor fruits of Andaman Nicobar Island, having nutritional and ecological security and other points of view, the livelihood for the tribals of the island. We developed a number of technologies there. After working in tropical ecosystem, I worked in arid system at Bikaner for 4 to 5 years. And the other, this post-harvest institute, CIFET, at Abhor campus on post-harvest management of fruit crops and development of value-added products. After serving there for 8 years, I joined CITH Srinagar as a principal scientist and worked on diversification of crops, temperate crops particularly, and their processing and product diversification. From last 5 to 6 years, I'm posted as a director of this institute. And before going for the talk, I would like to describe about the institute, that is Center Institute for Temperate Horticulture. This institute established in 1994 and virtually started working in 1996-97. Located at Srinagar, Kashmir, the institute is having two regional stations, one at Uttarakhand, that is Mukteshwar, and one station at Dirang, that is in Arunachal Pradesh. The institute virtually started their research work in 1996-97. After 2-3 years it took to establish the institute. The mandate of the institute is to act as national repository of germplasm and scientific information on temperate horticulture crops, to undertake basic strategic and applied research on temperate horticultural crops in collaboration with national and international agencies to enhance productivity and quality. Particularly, we work for development of variety, identification of variety, evaluation of varieties, keeping in mind the quality and production in view, and biotic and abiotic stress in particular, and to serve as center of training for human resource development and transfer of technology. And the talk of the day, that is diversification of temperate fruits in response to climate shift. That is also one of the additional mandate of the institute. As far as the institute is concerned, we are having good number of germplasm in case of fruits, vegetables, ornamental plants, medicinal and aromatic plants. Particularly in case of fruits, we are having three categories, that is palm fruits, stone fruits, and nuts, and some of the minor fruits also. In total, in case of fruits, we are having 1,323 number of germplasm. And in case of particularly in palm, 445. In case of stone fruits, we are having 246. And in case of nuts, 398. And others, we are having 224. In case of vegetables, we are having a good number here. That is the temperate vegetables, 1,075. And ornamentals, 329. In addition to these, we are having medicinal and aromatic plants, that is 33. In total, we are having 4,073 germplasm here. As far as achievements of the institute are concerned, development of varieties, we are having 10 varieties we have developed in case of walnut. In case of apple, we are having 4 hybrids in pipeline to be released, and 1 variety for the low-chill regions. In case of cherry, we are having 3 varieties. In apricot, 3 varieties. Garlic, 2 varieties. Onion, 2 varieties. And we have licensed and we have developed processing technology and licensed three products we have licensed and commercialized for the entrepreneurship in the state. Apart from that, very particular, I will mention that high density plantation in apple and nuts and other stone fruits, we have developed technology here, which has been adopted by the state horticulture department, university, and other farmers. And we are having a very well managed canopy and tree architect system. Under this, we are having one big project, that is the network project with the other institutes and other crops also, other stations at regional stations and other temperate regions. Our one of the goal is popularization of walnut in temperate regions, rejuvenation of old and senile orchards. Apart from that, our institute has worked on micropropagation protocol, which has been standardized and developed in case of apple, cherry, clonal rootstock, that lilium, saffron combs, and strawberry. And molecular characterization has been done, walnut, peach, plum, saffron, and apple. Virus indexing has been done in apple and other fruit crops. We have developed predictor and planner for almond and mobile application, which is a nutrient deficiency diagnoser and manager for apple, in which we are having nutrient deficiency, this symptoms, and how to go for rectification and management of these deficiencies. This all is available on mobile application, which is applicable to the farms. Intensive production technology for production of comb and high saffron yield standardized in the institute. Intensive production technology, which has been developed and given to the farmers, the yield has been increased from 2 kg to 6.5 kg per hectare. Apart from that, we are working extensively for the extension and training programs. All these technologies we are demonstrating at farmers' field under different programs, Miragao, Miragoro, TSP program, and then SCSP program. And other institute linked with the university, linked with the KVKs and other NGOs, and many this progressive farmers, they are our partners, and nurseries. All these technologies are given to the end users. This was about the institute and myself. Now I'll go for the main topic, that is diversification of the temperate fruits and nuts. Yeah, it's a topic, topic that is diversification of temperate fruits and nuts. The agroclimatic conditions in most parts of Himalayan hill states, which extends from Jammu and Kashmir in north to Arunachal Pradesh in east, has a unique and fragile ecosystem that is highly suitable for growing temperate fruit crops like apple, pear, peach, plum, apricot, almond, walnut, pecan nut, kiwi fruits, strawberry, hazelnut, pistachio nut, and other small fruits and berries. In this region, the livelihood of more than 65% of the people is dependent on horticulture and draws about 60% of its gross domestic product from the surrounding ecological resources. Temperate horticulture is therefore the backbone of hill state economy. These are the temperate, very, very important temperate fruit and nuts, apple, pear, palm fruits in case of Queens also is there. In case of stone fruits, we are having plum, apricot, sweet cherry, peach, prune, nectarine, walnut, almond, chestnut, hazelnut, pecan nut, pistachio. Minor nut fruit crops are there, very small fruits and soft fruits, strawberry, grapes, rosehip. In future crops, we are having kiwi fruit and olive. About this all diversification of these fruits, we will be discussing in detail. As far as the area production and productivity of temperate fruit is concerned, if we see from 1960 to 61 to 2017-18 and then our present conditions also, dramatic, there is a change. There is a progress in area expansion from 0.82 to 6.50 lakh hectares and production from 3.03 to 40.0 lakh tons. And productivity has also increased significantly. This is the mandate crops of our institute, that is the Center Institute for Temperate Horticulture. We are mostly working on apple, walnut, almond, pear, peach, kiwi fruit, olive crop, plum, apricot, sweet cherry, strawberry, quince, nectarine, grapes, chestnut, hazelnut, pistachio, pecan, rose hips, ribes, blackberry, saffron, kala zira, chili, broccoli, kale, parsley, lettuce, Chinese cabbage, gladiolus, carnation, tulip, astromeria, gerbera, lilium. This is all broad about the fruit, vegetables, and ornamentals, what we are working here. As far as the topic of the day is concerned, I would like to mention that the identification of new species, their characterization, conservation, and sustainable utilization is the key to improve agriculture productivity and sustainability, therefore contributing to national development, food security, and poverty alleviation. Of this, as you know, that favorable climatic conditions always determine the fruit production at its quality. Climate change in Western Himalayas in terms of early summer, delayed winter, that is a shift in chilling conditions, erratic rainfall are the main developmental factors which affect growth, fruit set, and fruit development. So there is a tremendous scope for production and product diversification of temperate fruits, which can fit in changing climatic situations and can tolerate abiotic stress under fragile Himalayan ecosystem. Then we see about the greenhouse effect and the global warming. Climate is driven by solar energy. 30% of scattered back to space, 70% warms the Earth's surface. That is, Earth emits the energy back as infrared and thermal radiation. Then there is a greenhouse effect, that water vapor, CO2, ozone, methane, nitrous oxide, halocarbons, and other industrial gases. Then there is a greenhouse effect. That is, the greenhouse gases block infrared radiation to cause a natural greenhouse effect, which keep the planet about 30 degrees centigrade warmer than it would otherwise be. Then anthropogenic forcing. The level of greenhouse gases except water vapor are rising as a result of human activity, industry, agriculture, and land use change, that which leads to enhance greenhouse effect. Then there is a global warming that the climate system adjusts to rising greenhouse gases to keep the global energy budget in balance through rising average. Then temperature, particularly that of surface temperature, have risen about 0.7 degree centigrade since the early 20th century and about 0.5 degree in increase in 1978. And by 2100, it will be 1.4 to 5.8. Then there are uncertainties. That is the global warming, even by a small rise in temperature, will be accompanied by many changes, which cloud cover and wind patterns, ocean currents, etc., which may produce positive or negative feedback. This is the global mean temperature in the change. We'll see that global spirit temperature are increasing at 0.7 degree centigrade per decade in last 100 years and 1.7 degree centigrade in last 25 years. This is the sea level rise in 20th century, by that is 0.17 meter. A maximum area covered by seasonally frozen ground has increased about 7% in northern hemisphere. This is about concentration of carbon dioxide have increased from 280 ppm to about 379 ppm. This is the warming. As far as agroecological zones of Kashmir, particularly I will describe here, we are having Eastern Ladakh, that is a cold, hyper, very, very hyper arid. Then we are having Western Ladakh, and then northwestern Kashmir, high mountains, central Kashmir, Kashmir and Jammu Himalayas, western Jammu Himalayas, and then western Jammu Himalayas, Shivalik, Jammu Plains, where the temperature is cold and variation is there up to hot and humid. This is the ecological zones of Uttarakhand. We are having a terrain and lower dune area, upper dune area, that is Bawal area, and then middle Garhwal area, Kamaun, and upper Garhwal area, cold arid in case of Musarrali and Badrinath. The crops, there is a suitable crops which are for different this ecozones of Uttarakhand. This low chilling peach, pear, plum, apricot, most of the vegetables, peach, plum, apricot, and in case of upper Garhwal hills, apple, peach, plum, apricot, and walnut. And in case of cold, we are having apple, walnut, sea, bakthar, some selective vegetables. Then horticulture crop, which responds to this climate change. This is effect of rise in temperature. Average mean temperature in Kashmir province has rise of 1.45 degree Celsius, while in Jammu it is at 2.32. Effect of temperature on plant growth and development. The most biological activity at low, almost to zero, below 5 degree centigrade. Higher summer temperature favors plant growth if other factors are not limiting. And then temperatures unlikely to reach level rise to 50 to 100 years, at which they cause direct damage to plants, especially that is, we can say that is a very hot and cooking of the tree, cooking of the plant, rather than causing indirect damage by increasing water stress, although the possibility cannot be ruled out by very hot days, especially in case of greenhouses. Then effect on flowering is there, mild winter temperature and warm spring, bud burst in advance and onset of growth causes earlier. That is, for example, in case of apple, when tree sprout 2 to 3 weeks, normally apple tree sprouts in mid-April. Flowering may be delayed in mean temperature increases. Higher average temperature leads to early date of bloom. Due to change in bud opening in March, bud are very susceptible to frost damage. This I would like to mention here. This blooming of the flower, this in case of slow snowfall in case of February. There is a flowering onset in case of in February. There is a temperature rise, and almonds and other stone fruits, they start flowering. but abruptly there is a change in climate, and then the this low chill will be there. There will be snowfall also, and then ultimately it leads to fall of flowers and affects fruit set and yield. And then effect on yield, the failure in case of apple to change into their specific red shades, increase in sunburn in apple, high temperature affects fruit flesh and cell breakdown. Temperature on dormancy, it is very dominant here. Low warming scenario, less than 1 degree centigrade, and unlikely to affect vernalization of the high chill fruits. And if warming scenario exceeds 1.5 degree centigrade, it would significantly increase the risk of prolonged dormancy. Dormancy is increased in case of stone fruits and palm fruits. Mild winter in results in delayed or irregular flowering, reduced fruit set and extended flowering period. Development and the later expansion of leaf and flower bud in pairs in case of berries. Effect on frost susceptibility, it's very important. Increase in winter temperatures anticipated in all scenarios will result in very substantial increase in number of days with temperature above freezing and above 5 degrees centigrade, thus extending and advancing the growing season. Frost damage can also occur during the dormant periods. This is one of the case in case of abrupt flood in Rajbagh area of Srinagar. I want to mention that flooding due to abrupt meltdown of the snow as a result of high temperature in Kashmir is an unusual occurrence now. Effect on disease and insects will be there. Wetter and warmer winters will favor diseases. Drier and warmer summers favor diseases such as powdery mildew and sooty bark diseases. And in recent past, it has been seen that occurrence of storms, stormy type of rains in Kashmir conditions have increased bacterial gomosis. In rare season, annual temperature of 2 degree butterflies will appear 2 to 3 weeks earlier. Effect on weed infestation will be there. Changing climatic scenario, what is the inference there? In case of winter, there is lack of sufficient chilling hours, that is less than 1,200 hours. Insufficient winter precipitation, that is snow. In case of spring, low temperature during bloom, which leads to very poor fruit set. Warmer temperature, desiccation of flower parts, and hail and spring frost kill flowers. In case of summer, very high temperature, a prolonged drought is there. Small fruits will be there in case of summer. Heavy and frequent hails and fruit damage and return bloom, which affects quality and yield. This is the physiography of the hill terrain. Steep topography is there, shallow soil, poor fertility, and soil erosion and runoff is there. Less adoption of in situ soil conservation programs. Lack of certified planting materials around this, this is a problem of the temperate area. Variable planting material due to seedling type of rootstock and lack of progeny plants. Lack of rootstock for high density plantation. Lack of nursery certification plants. This is the management programs which are required very, very immediate attention. Inadequate pollination is there. Lack of synchronization. For example, in case of golden delicious, we are having very alternate bearing and late maturity. Red delicious, we are having heavy this crop load and small, very, very small fruits and faster vegetative growth. When the proportion is there, that is less than 5% to 10% in hailstone areas. And pollinators, actually in case of farmers, the farmers generally, they are ignorant about the honeybee use for pollination. Spraying up pesticide during flowering will kill bee fauna. This slide I want to show that there is a non-synchronization of flowering of main and pollinator cultivars due to lack of sufficient chilling hour accumulation. that is a climate change direct effect on food set and flowering. Insect pest and diseases will appear due to this climate change, particularly this mite, red mite, San Jose scale, woolly apple root borers, premature leaf fall is there, and then apple scab and root rot. These are the pictures I want to show that how it affects the this diseases affect the fruit and vegetative growth. What can be the strategies for there? Varietal shift to third generation, that is the need. High density planting, supplementing pollination practices, in situ soil moisture conservation, and rainwater harvesting, high technology precision farming, drip irrigation, INM, IPM, organic farming, searching new vistas in cold and northeast Himalayas. Then the effect of CO2 on plant growth is there. Forms the structure skeleton of the plant. In other factors remains favorable. Increased carbon dioxide concentration will lead to greater rates of photosynthesis in plants. Doubling of carbon dioxide concentration will lead to approximately a 40 to 50% increase in growth of plant. Then effect on bud burst will be there. Timing, cessation of growth, bud burst, altered concentration of carbohydrate, plant growth hormones concentration will be altered. Dormancy status of the tree will be changed. The early bud burst will already be experienced in various temperate fruit crops, particularly apple, almond, and apricot. Then effect on flowering and fruiting will be there. Effect of CO2 on leaf fall will be there. Effect of CO2 on yield, average yields will increase by about 40 to 5% due to increase in carbohydrate concentration of tissues. Effect of CO2 on stromal opening will be there. Effect of CO2 on water use efficiency will be there. Effect on fruit quality, definitely it will affect the high fruit dry matter, fructose, glucose, and TSS. Effect of CO2 on pest resistance, it will be there. What can be the strategies for mitigation effect to get the rid of this effect of climate change? Breeding strategies are required. And then development of new genotypes having resistance to high temperature and CO2 concentration, marker assistant selection and development of transgenic having resistance to biotic and abiotic resistance, development of genotypes having resistance to heat and drought, crop diversification, which is the talk of the day we will be discussing in detail. Particularly this shifting and diversification of traditional system of apple cultivation, apple orcharding, then we have to go for high density plantings. At CITH, we have done a number of experiments, a number of models we have studied, modified central leader system we compared with that traditional system, then spindle bush system, head and spread system, cotton system, spandrel system, vertical axis system, and different rootstocks. And then we have seen an M9 rootstock. When we are going for high density plantation, we can go for plantation density of different 2,222 to 8,888. But we have seen that 3,333 plants, which can give us the yield up to 58 to 62 tons per hectare. And when we compare it that with traditional system, that is 8 to 10 tons per hectare. And in case of modified central system, if we are adopting very, very good technologies also, but yield will be there up to 30 tons per hectare. If we are adopting this high density planting system and diversification of the system from the traditional to high density system, modified central system, if we compare this planar system, vertical axis system, tremendous change in production quality and income is there. Doubling the farming income, horticulture is one of the aspects, but we can go for four times increase in the yield and income of the apple this cultivation by adopting this high density planting system. These are the varieties which are suitable for this high density planting system, that Oregon Spur, Super Cheap, Geromine. Then this is the close up of this different varieties, Star Crimson, Silver Spur, Red Fuji. This high density plantation, if we are diversifying our system from the traditional to high density planting system in apple, then large plant spacing in case of the low density, when we are going for the traditional, we can, in high density, we can go for managed trees of required height and growth, a higher number of trees per unit area, as I have told you that 3,333 plants can be accommodated in 1 hectare. Proper plant architect and canopy, a spanner and this tall spindle system, we can go. Maximum utilization of solar radiation and juvenile period will be less and early returns will be there. If you are going for this apple, almond, and peach, plum, and apricot, we have seen that tremendous increase in yield and qualities there. These are the different splendid system, this flowering in case of apple, vertical axis in case of apple, and white trellis in peach. Peach and nectarine, it has given very good quality and yield of the fruit. Yeah, this is scientifically managed canopy system. This is the view, overview. This is Oregon spur, Miller study spur, red chief, Tedman earlier, and Corad Fuji, Skylet spur, Washington, super chief. This is the close-up, different varieties. Silver spur, super chief, Oregon spur, red chief. This red delicious and all these. Apart from that, the need of the day, we have to go for some varieties. We have to develop some hybrids. Institute is going to release 4 hybrids. This in case of apple, that is CITH, Amul, Pride, Prime, and Hybrid. This motive of this development of these hybrids were apple scab, this season of the fruit, crispness, and quality, firmness, crispness, and then color of the fruit, as well as juice content and post-harvest life of the fruit. These 4 hybrids will be released from the institute. This is also one of the development of the CITH. There is a need when we are talking about the diversification of the system, diversification of the varieties, then we have to go for low chilling cultivars suitable for areas with low chill accumulation varieties. We are having different varieties. We are the which the varieties need 300 or less hours of chilling. Beverly Hill, these are the variety: Beverly Hill, Gordon, Tropical Beauty, Parlin, Anna Beauty, Naomi, Tropic Sweet, Tropic Mac, Michael, Mayan, Tama, and Dorset Gold, and Pettingill, Yellow Bullfrog, and the Winter Banana. These are the close up of the photographs of the varieties which are coming out in as a low chill varieties. This is the low chill variety released from CITH Srinagar, that is Apple Load 1. It is suitable for this Mukteshwar area and low chill areas. Future requirements. When we are going for diversification, we have to keep something in mind to the development of designer trees and model plants. With balanced shoot and root growth for maximum productivity. This can be through gene transfer and breeding programs also. We are having different varieties, Scarlet Sentinel and Golden Sentinel, few varieties we are having at institute also. In future, when there is a urban horticulture development in temperate fruits also, where the chilling requirements are less in apple varieties, those varieties can be grown in pots, at terraces, and as in the front of the houses also. So that is one of the venture which can be from the traditional system to this system, but still some research is required in case of this type of this orcharding and diversification. We have to go for see that how they behave towards the climate change and their test this pest and disease management in the future is to be looked in particular. Varietal shift, when we are talking about the this diversification, then diversification of the varieties. From the second generation varieties, we have seen that early coloring strains, that is Top Red, Vance Delicious, Hardman, Standard, Skyland, Supreme, and this bright and early. Then spur type, we are there, red chief, Oregon spur, silver spur, dwarf, and well spur. But in case of third generation, mostly these varieties are self-fruitful. Vestibula pink and all these number of varieties are there. Scarlet Gala, Red Fuji, and all that. We have to go for these third generation varieties. These are the close-up of the varieties, which are the diversification of the varieties, and they are adopting well under high density cropping system. Varietal diversification. I will. Apart from that, we have our institute has developed 10 varieties of walnut. They are very good in quality as well as the tree structure is concerned. We have developed the propagation techniques also. Nut character yield and kernel recovery is very, very significantly high and very superior. And we are having a well-versed program for the popularization of the walnut varieties in temperate areas. Apart from that, diversification of this apricot, apart from this traditional and other varieties, that is Harcourt as a Czech, we have developed three varieties, CITH apricot 1, 2, and 3. And the average yield is 20 to 30 tons per hectare. This is also the part of the diversification of the temperate fruit, particularly in case of stone fruits. We are having in case of cherry, three varieties, which are superior in quality, adapting well to temperate ecosystem. Then agronomical management strategies to be required in the future if we are going for diversification, well-versed and well-managed agronomical practices are to be required. Biotechnological innovative studies are to be required, especially data for molecular characterization of different traits when we are relating them to biotic and abiotic stress, and transformation of plants from C3 to C4 plants, and gene pyramiding against biotic and abiotic stress, in vitro conservation of rare and useful species for future use. And then crop improvement studies are to be adopted well in case of when we are going for the diversification. Development of agrotechnics, plant protection studies, we have to plan, strengthen our system, survival system in case of pests and diseases, to study the pattern of increasing climatic variability and change could be lead to rapid movement of pathogens and insect diseases. Post-harvest management is to be looked after. Development of cost-effective storage technique, development of varieties having longer shelf life, studies on mitigation of post-harvest spoilage. And then in case of when we are adopting all diversification and all that, we have to go to manage the pollination in a very, very systematic. This is a very, very important aspect in case of temperate fruits in particular, I will say. This importance of pollinator in temperate fruits, you are well aware about this, is all temperate fruits require pollination to set fruits. So there are some conditions which are necessary to satisfy the cross-pollination. The bloom of the pollinizer variety must bloom with the main variety. The pollinizer variety must have viable diploid pollen. The pollinizer variety must be located near the this tree where we are producing it. Bees and other insects must be present in orchard. Feed blossoms such as dandelion, mustard, and wild radish should not be present in quantity since they attract bee away from the fruit tree blossoms. These are the characteristics of a good pollinizer. Compatibility, I have explained about this also, all these characters. Then there is a requirement for pollinizer displacement also. So different systems after the rows, we can make different rows of this pollinizers. Different models are there. Then pollinators are required. Insect, wind, and water are the main important. In case of requirement of beehives in temperate fruit orchard, we should look after this very particularly, particularly in case of almond, apple, apricot, cherry, plum, and strawberry. There is a particular requirement of beehives per hectare. So we should take care of this proportion and all these beehive colony should be there sufficient. In case of pollinizer cultivar varieties for apple is concerned, for early bloomer we are having Red Macintosh and Black Ben Davis, Red Gold, Tidyman Early, Worcester, and Manchurian. There are mid bloomers also, and number of there, Winter Banana, Lord London, and Summer Queen, Snow Day, and Gloucester, Gala, Spartan, Crimson Gold, Yellow Transparent, and York Imperial, Jonathan, Lodi, and all that. For late blooming also, we are having Golden Delicious, very, very good pollinizer, Golden Spur, Rome Beauty, Granny Smith, Worcester Pearman, and Golden Horseman, and then Stars for Gold. In case of pair, we are having compatible pollinizers for European and Asian plum pair also. Barlet, we are having Anjo, Bose, and Kumain, Clap, Every Conference. In different cultivars, we are having different pollinizers. We should look after the compatibility factor while keeping these pollinizers in concentration. In case of plum also, plum are self-fruitful, partially self-fertile and self-sterile. In case of compatible pollinizer per plum, we are having different cultivars. Burbank, Santa Rosa, Satsuma, we are having different pollinizers. These pollinizers should be taken in due consideration, keeping in mind the compatible characters of the pollinizer and the variety to get the maximum pollination and fruit set and fruiting in return. In case of cherry, we are having this pollinizer plan should be well managed. In case of cultivar Bing, we are having different pollinizers, Lambert, Rainer, Napoleon, Stella, and Compact Stella, and other varieties. That is Garden Bing and all the others. We are having a well-programmed set of pollinizers for this all these varieties. In case of walnut, particularly walnut are self-fruitful and cross-pollinated. This is monoecious fruit crop. As the maturity of the male and female flowers do not synchronize, that's a dichogamy. So planting of two or more cultivars or seedlings are suggested there. This is the, we have done some study on this this walnut to go for degree of dichogamy and then dichogamy and then manage this orchard system. Keeping in mind these characteristics of the particular variety. In case of almond, we are having a cross incompatibility status among almond varieties of Kashmir, Makhdoom, Barbat, Waris, Shalimar, and all these pollinizers. We have well defined these recommendations from which are non-compatible and compatible. This chart and this combination should be considered while keeping in mind the pollination program. And then role of rootstock is very, very important there. We should go for the particular type of rootstock. There are attributes of an ideal rootstock. We can take one by one. That of, in case of apple, we are having rootstock MM19, MM111, 106, M25, M27, M7, M26, M9, and 793. These are different characteristics which can fit into the rootstock and can be managed for the apple. Then we are having clonal rootstocks for pear also. That quince we are having. Then different rootstocks, Adam 321 and quince, we are having different series and all the other rootstocks. They are having some remarks. They are particularly how they fit into the system. For example, quince, I will explain a little. Dwarfer of original two clones that released from HRI e-smelling. This is easy to propagate. We can go for Adam 332, that is slightly more invigorous than Queen C, but less than Queen A. Then rootstocks, there are different type of rootstock, seedling rootstock, clonal rootstock. I will not go about this in detail about this. Especially characteristics of different this rootstocks of apple, this MM199, how it fits into the characteristics of the tree, that is a, whether it is a precocious or high production or high temperature tolerant to different biotic and abiotic stresses. We can choose the this rootstocks, keeping in mind this water availability, slope of the soil, wind velocity, and other biotic abiotic stress conditions. And in case of peach also, we are having a well-planned rootstock system. That's a peach into almond. We are having Hansen and GF677. And then peach into plum, we are having dwarfing and less vigorous, more precocious, and best results with plum Sean. Plum rootstocks, which are Mariana and European plum, there is a suitable rootstock plan is there. They can be adopted. The cherry rootstocks are there. walnut rootstocks, Jugonus regia is there, that is Persian walnut, and then Hindsi and Jugonus nigra, paradox, and other rootstocks are there. But in Kashmir Valley, we are using this local rootstock. Almond rootstocks are there. Future rootstock it needs are very, very important points that we should take in consideration, that dwarfing rootstocks in vigor range between M27 and M26 with following attributes. Good tree, this anchorage to reduce the cost of the support system, strong drought tolerance, resistant to fire blight, and then invigorating this rootstock for regions where poor and shallow soil and extreme climatic conditions make the use of dwarfing rootstocks impractical. What are the priorities in keeping in mind when the diversification is there? Then effects of climate change and horticulture sectors are still uncertain. In the light of possible global warming, researchers should more emphasis on development of heat and drought resistant crops. Research is needed to define the current limits to these resistance and the feasibility of manipulation through modern genetic technique. This climate change impacts are to be looked not in isolation, but in conjunction with all the aspects of agriculture and allied sectors. At the regional level, those charged with planning for resource allocation, including land, water, and agriculture development, should take climate change into account. And continuation of current and new initiatives to research potential, minimize the effect of climate change at farm, regional, national, and international level. Part of that diversification, particularly I would like to mention here, there are n number of untapped fruit crops having potential for nutritional security and livelihood and entrepreneurship in particular, I will say. These are indigenous sources which are available, which can be taken in consideration while adopting this untapped, unutilized, neglected fruits, but are having ecological, nutritional, and other entrepreneur and market potential. In case of Pyrus, Pyrus pyrcea is there. Prunus species are there. Ficus species are there. Ficus carica, Ficus palmata. Then ribes are there. Rubus is there. Vitus is there. Sorbus, Fragaria, Duchenneia, Maria, America. Pinus is there. Diasporus is there. Corals are there. Weberum are there. Ziziphus is there. Ziziphus mauritiana, Ziziphus numularia can be taken into consideration. Carissa is there. In case of citrus also in some parts. Then Umbilica is there. And then Hepebo, as far as you know about this food. But there is still some scope of introducing some other this minor foods also. That is, exotic sources are there. We can go for pineapple guava. That is Foggia slovene. Chinese bear is there, Japanese persimmon, queens, we can go, many strains are there, Ceratonia is there, pistachia is there, grapes are there, rubus, ripes, other strains, new varieties are there, husk tomato, strawberry, mulberry, fig, medlar, ciborium, cornus, hazelnut, many other fruits are there, which can be considered. Particularly when we discuss about this alternate foods, when there is a diversification and climate change, there is a need of some fruits which are which can be grown in abiotic and biotic stress conditions. Berries is one of the fruit which can be alternate food crop for the future. Commonly grown berries in the world are blackberries and dewberries, in case these are the rubus species. Blueberries are there, that is a high bush, low bush, and rabbit eye, that is Vaccinium carabosum, angustifolium, and anchae. Cranberries are there, that is Vaccinium macrocarpon. Gooseberries and currants are there, ripes are there, that is raspberries, both red and black. Strawberries are there, rubus species, Fragaria species. Particularly about the berries, particularly I will say that they are considered very soft fruits and include botanically different types of fruits such as blackberries, blueberries, strawberries, cranberries, gooseberries, currants, raspberries. These berries are very hardy in nature and can be grown in adverse climatic conditions. That is which choose as one of the alternate fruit. These fruits are used in desserts as well as processing. We'll discuss in detail about these. They can be canned, frozen, made into many products like jam, jellies, and preserves. In addition to their use as the food product, many of these berries, such as cranberries, blueberries, and blackberries, are popular for their medicinal properties. The extract of these berries have been used as herbal remedies as well as defined pharmaceutical products. Some of their applications are as antiseptic, diuretic, antioxidant, cardioprotective, anti-inflammatory, and anti-carcinogenic agents. In recent years, these has been renewed interest in the elucidation of medicinal properties and nature of active phytochemicals in these berries. If we go for the chemical composition of these berries, if we are see that these blackberry, craneberry, gooseberry, raspberry, strawberries, their composition, chemical composition, and nutritional aspect, they are very rich in sugars, acidity. They are having moderate and acceptable acidity. TSS and SDT blend is quite acceptable and very favorable. Ascorbic acid, carotene, thiamine, riboflavin, nicotinic acid, minerals, particularly phosphorus, potassium, sodium, calcium, magnesium. These are the all these vitamins and minerals. They are very essential for a healthy life, particularly in the recent past during this COVID-19 attack. It has been seen that these small fruits, neglected fruits, berries, and all these having very good quality as far as their nutritional value, this nutrient and mineral aspect is concerned for developing the immune system in the body. These are to be considered as one of the vital fruits for the future. Future fruits and their nutraceuticals. I will take some slides about these. The term nutraceutical is derived from the word nutrition, and pharmaceutical is a food. That product provides health and medicines. They include the prevention and treatment of the disease. So as far as this soft fruits are concerned, these berries, these neglected, these minor fruits are untapped fruits are concerned. They are very, very good in nutrition as well as for these pharmaceutical properties. In order to provide maximum intracellular protection, these are strategically this compartmentalized in the cell and offer protection that can be classified first line of defense in case of health. It comprises preventing antioxidants that act by quenching of O2 and decomposition of H2O2 and chelation of this metal ion and enzymes. Second line of defense, that is antioxidant, belongs to the category defense, include glutathione. And third line of defense and fourth line of defense, all these are provided by these foods. As far as phytochemical and their health benefits are concerned, they are very rich in polyphenols, anthocyanidines, phytoestrogens, terpenoids, carotenoids, limonoids, phytosterols, gluconolates, and then polysaccharides. As far as these flavonoids are concerned, that is anthocyanidines, the best source are blueberries, blackberries, craneberry, raspberry, blackberry, and then strawberry, cherries, plum, pomegranate. As far as flavonoid glycosides are concerned, orange juice, lemon, and this is in general, and flavonoids, citrus fruits and their juices. Here I want to mention that this polyphenols. Berries, these untapped fruits which we are discussing, they are very rich in polyphenols. So they can be consumed for the development of the immune of the body. As far as the quantities of this antioxidant and polyphenol and their class in some commonly used foods are there, I will take example of few of them. As far as this flavanol is concerned, we will say that raspberry is very 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 good in catechin in case of phenol. This black grape in case of flavanol, blueberry is in case of flavanol, and then we can say the cherry at in case of catechins, peach in case of catechins, apple in case of catechins, and strawberry catechins. And then black currants, this anthocyanin, strawberry anthocyanin, red wine, part of the these crops product, that is anthocyanin, and the black grape anthocyanin. This I mean that many fruits they are very rich in anthocyanin and catechins. As far as black berries are concerned, they compose significantly high amount of phenolic flavonoid phytochemicals such as anthocyanin, ellagic acid and tannin. So this blackberries have a ORAC value quite high, which can be consumed, and one of the very good source of this phytochemicals and all that. These currants are there. Their nutraceutical value, if we are considering, they are carry significantly high amount of phenolic flavonoid phytochemical called as anthocyanins. Blackberries can have potential health effects against cancer, aging, and inflammation, and neurological diseases also. Berries are there. They are very this high value, having very good nutritional importance. Blueberries are among the highest antioxidant value when we see this ORAC value of the 100 gram this fresh blueberry, if we are concerned. The 5,562 TE, that is the Trolex equivalents. The oxidant value of this largely comes from the polyphenols. Then we are having cranberries. Their also nutritional value is very, very high, can be considered as one of the fruit for consideration. Gooseberries are there. Gooseberries are low in calories, and 100 gram of fresh berries holds just 44 calories. You can see that how important and how useful it is. This is for this health conscious people taking the this gooseberries. And then kiwi fruit, as you know, that kiwi fruit is more moderately good in calories, comparable to that of grapes. If we compare it, 100 grams of kiwi fruit sold 61 calories. Nonetheless, it has several health, aging, antioxidant, mineral, and vitamin, other fiber properties. This fruit is also adapting very, very good in some of the temperate areas. Particular selection of the varieties is to be taken into consideration. Raspberries are there. They are very, very good nutraceutical values and having when we compare with other, even some of the main fruits. Strawberries are there. Strawberries is low in calorie and fat, but rich source of health promising phytonutrients, minerals, and vitamins that are essential for optimum health. Strawberries have significantly high amount of phenolic flavonoid phytochemical called anthocyanins and ellagic acid. The scientific studies have shown that the consumption of these berries may have potential health benefits against cancer, aging, inflammation, and neurological diseases also. As far as diversification is concerned, we have gone for this diversification in case of olive also. We have introduced some varieties of the olive crop in our this, Center Institute of Temperate Horticulture. And we have seen that some of the varieties can be, they can fit in this system and can be taken as one of the diversified crop. These varieties are the olive at CITH farm, which have performed better. These varieties are having this source from, we have got from the Italy, one of the project from the Italy ecosystem, Italy region. This Fantoia variety, Pendolin, a few Lucino, Cotains. We are having 18 varieties. Some of them are performing very good, and we have brought them in a compatible orchard system. Now these some of the part of the Udi region of the Kashmir and this Ramban area of the Kashmir, they are very suitable for olive crops. But we have seen in shifting climate this system in case of Srinagar also, these olive varieties, they are coming out very good. If this temperature and climate favors in the mid of October and in the first week of November, then this crop gives out very good yield and recovery, oil recovery. This is about this performance of these varieties. These are the varieties which are performing very good in this our system. Pecan nut and chestnut as a minor nuts, they are having a very good scope here. We have done some work here also, hazelnut and pistachio also. In pecan nut, we have introduced we have collected some of the genotypes which are coming out very good in this system. These pecan nut at CITH were having some collections. They will be further multiplied, and recommendations will be given for the farmers. A hazelnut, we have done good work from last 10 years. Some 12 types genotypes we have seen and evaluated at our institute. They are giving very good results, and planting materials also available. We are giving to the farmers also. These are the hazelnut varieties at CITH Srinagar. We have some genotypes. We have some introductions also. These are the close-up of the fruit, these nuts, minor nuts, this of hazelnut we are getting from our institute farm. Pistachio also we have seen, it behaves very good in this ecosystem. We have to go for intensive study for further introduction of some of the varieties, some of the genotypes in Central Asian parts also. We can introduce and evaluate. So far we have introduced some of, we are having six types here, which are fruiting and different pistachio selections in CITH farm. And they are being multiplied, and further studies are going on. These nuts can be one of the diversified nuts in the future crops of the temperate system. Raspberries are there. We can go for some of the varieties. These varieties are exotic varieties, but there is a scope. Some of this variety we have seen here in our system also, but the need some more varieties to be seen and see the performance at temperate system of temperate ecosystem of the Kashmir and other parts of the India having temperate system. Raspberry varieties, very good composition. We have seen that they are very good in nutrients and all that. These are some of the variety, blackberry, black raspberry and purple raspberry and blackberries. In case of blackberries, we are having good genotypes in locally in Kashmir Valley also. They are having moderate size of fruit, but some introduction of the new varieties will give boost to the development of berry research and development of some of the varieties suitable for this system. Then black currants are there. They are giving up very good in Ladakh area and Kargil area also, Batalik area, and we have introduced here also. But still more work is to be needed to work on the black currants and all the some new varieties to be introduced. Gooseberries, some of the selections we have seen performing better. Blueberries also we are on the way to work on this, but still we need some system to develop for the management of these varieties. Cranberries can be fit very good in this ecosystem, having a very good nutritional and other mineral composition is considered. Cape gooseberries, we have done elaborate work on 10 years study, and this composition is very good in having very good protein to vitamins. We have seen they are very good here. 21 varieties we have seen here, and three genotypes are behaving very good and giving very good yield in temperate system. And these varieties can also grow in some of the subtropical areas also. We are having some network program also, where we are giving this Cape gooseberry seeds to the researchers and to the some of the entrepreneurs also. Kiwi, we have seen that Bruno and Hayward variety, they are very good performing in our system. But in Arunachal Pradesh and Himachal Pradesh, that of Solon area, this Kiwi is performing better. So some of the areas in that areas can be further expanded, some further varieties can be introduced there. But in Arunachal Pradesh, they are performing very good. But in Kashmir, we have to see still some more varieties to see that how they behave and give their good quality fruits. As far as this product diversification is concerned, here I will mention some of the berries and some minor fruits, some of the nuts also, which are having product diversification values also. They can be of medicine values. Blackberries, we can make juice, wine, jam, syrup. They can be used for the cure of diarrhea, gout, arthritis, and many other diseases also. Likewise, that blueberries, craneberries, and gooseberries, they are having a very good scope for making jam, juices, syrup, concentrate, sweetened, dried craneberries, frozen craneberries, sliced craneberries, jam, jelly, sauces, cupcakes. They are very good antiseptic, diuretic, anti-inflammatory, anti-hyperglycemic, and anti-carcinogenic effects are there. Appetizer, many of these fruits are appetizers, direct use whether we are using the product or some other in other forms, they are very useful for the health benefit. These are again the raspberry, strawberry, pineapple, guava, Chinese bear, Japanese persimmon. We have seen this n number of products. They are available in the market. Institute has developed this process technology. I will be explaining in coming slides. A very good scope is there to make these products. Actually, we have to go for novel products, which are having a very good market in national as well as international market. So this process technology, we have to increase and refine the technology so that we can get the product of very good quality. And in addition to that, we have to go for packaging and the storage facilities, and their storage life should be quite good so that they can be available in the market for a long period of time. Here I will have shown this many products which can be prepared out of these minor fruits. Berries and other untapped fruits. As far as product diversification of the CITH and scope from the other institutes is also concerned, I will explain a few of the slides. I have already explained how these can be made many diseases. Some of the products against the diseases having the pharmaceutical values also. As far as this apricot is concerned, the drying up apricot in the Ladakh area and other parts of the area where the apricot is grown, but there is a scope for making more value-added products. This Osmo air-dried this apricot product have been developed at our institute, and we have used different drying techniques, but we can make some polyhouses, poly tunnels, and all that we can dry in those tunnels also. Apart from that, this cross flow air, air dryer can be used for making the product. This is the product, one of the product we have produced in our institute. This product has been given, this technology has been given to the local farmers, local entrepreneurs. They are adopting and making the product. And the training, well-defined training is to be given to the, particularly to the these producers of the apricot producers of Kargil area and Ladakh area. This is apricot fruit bar. This is one of the fruit, this novel product from our institute. This apricot fruit bar, particularly, I would like to mention that this is excellent texture, having color, aroma, taste, chewing quality with no sticking character, and have acceptable microbial load and least browning, and can be stored up to 9 months without loss in this quality, nutrition, and appeal. This product we have applied for patent. This product is on the way to the getting patent to the institute. And this technology has been licensed and taken by the local lady entrepreneur of the valley. This is the Cape gooseberry products. We have make 3-4 products out of those. This fruit bar, jam, and osmodehydrated cape gooseberry products, which are being taken by the farmers, by the entrepreneurs also. From the institute, we have developed, we are having a complete technological package for the users. This is one of this rose hips. This is the product which is otherwise waste in the jungles and all that. It is coming naturally in the fields, in the temperate areas, even subtropical to Ladakh arid, cold arid area. Vast diversity is there. They are very rich in vitamin C. They are having very good potential for making dehydrated products and value add to other products. Our institute has also made several products out of these. We have made dehydrated chunks, which can be a very good substitute for this, the people who are having the habit of chewing this gutka and tobacco and all that. Instead of that, they can chew this osmodehydrated chunks and all that, which are very, very good in taste while chewing and all that. We will give a desirable quantity of very, very good complete package of vitamin C. If I would like to mention in World War II, this rose hip products consumption directly in the jungles and all the soldiers, they have used it as one of the alternative to their food and protection from the this deficiency of the vitamin C during those war days. This is the plum food bar product of the CITH. This is also one of the product which are having a very good acceptability in the market. This is about the fruit bar of the Cape Gooseberry, called Cape Gooseberry products, Cape Gooseberry jam, how to make it, rose hip products, how to make these products out of these, complete package is there, making food bar. Before going for the future prospects, I would like to mention that we have developed the technologies of, for making the product diversification is concerned. This cherry blended juice product, and this apricot and plum juice blends we have developed, how to make the this nectars and other blended products of these. Apart from that, quince is one of the fruit which is having a very good potential in the valley. We have developed a technology apart from the marmalade and the other dehydrated products, but the very good candy. This technology we have developed in our institute, which can be one of the boost for the coming this years for making a very good toffee and candy from the quince product with low cost and very good packaging and very safe packaging and with minimum input. These housewives and these small entrepreneurs are this under the program of the our respected Prime Minister, that a startup program. These small farmers, small entrepreneurs, they can make their small industry as far as these products are concerned. And particularly in case of quince, I will say this, our institute is having a technology to make the candy out of these quince. This technology is available, we'll be giving to the entrepreneur. It will be available on our website and in our literature also. It can be well adopted by the entrepreneurs. Before sum up of this topic, I will go for some of the future perspectives which should be considered while going for the this type of work. To strengthen the work on genetic improvement, following strategies would be required for effective implement tools achieve the goal. That is systematic planning for exploration for minor temperate fruits, including this wild taxa, particularly for those crops whose economic importance is known for commercial exploitation. Need-based introduction, new crops, new species with specific traits, with the particular management system and plant quarantine, keeping in mind particularly disease and insect is concerned. Mostly minor temperate food crops are hardy and resilient. Once established in field gene bank, then agronomical practices should be developed, which are required for climatic conditions suitable to them in consideration. And then priority should be to conserve the material in yield, this in case of field gene bank, and protocol should be developed for in vitro conservation and cryopreservation as well. In situ conservation by the various government agencies and policy planners to protect the ecological niches where large variability is existing. For example, hazelnut in Pang, dry type apricot in Leh and Ladakh, and Kinnor, Chilgoza in Kinnor, and walnut in Jammu and Kashmir. Molecular characterization of underutilized temperate fruits will provide the information on identification of use full genes and other molecular markers, which will help in the genetic improvement work as well. There's a need to investigate value addition useful for products and processing and nutraceutical, ornamental, and other this potential applications of these fruit crops. Before going further, I'll say thank you to the organizers. I would like to mention that during my stay in tropical ecosystem, in island ecosystem in Port Blair, we, as a group, we developed a arboretum there, 118 genotypes, which are indigenous to those islands and having potential for the diversification and value addition we have conserved there. That that will be one of the small model for other ecosystems who can further create arboretum and go for further exploitation of these indigenous species. Thank you very much once again.
Sir, congratulations for wonderful talk. So many comments are there, so many questions. So we can take it one by one, if you allow, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Sir, first comment, Padam Sri Awardee Brahma Singh, he commented. So it is on your screen, sir. Technology.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. My pleasure to hear.
Sunil Sharma, he commented, sir.
Yeah, as far as this feasibility of plum cot is concerned, some of the plum cot genotypes we are having at our station, they are giving good results. Particularly, we are making blended this product juice, blend juices, plum cot and other this stone fruit juices. Plum cot is coming out good in temperate systems. Thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Manish, he is commenting, he is asking something, sir.
Okay, yes, I will respond. Yes, as far as Lovely Professional University is concerned, we are already having one MOU with your university. You can discuss with your registrar and all that. Further, if any this modification in MOU is concerned, our institute is very open for making collaborative work with your organization.
I am very
it is much not audible to me, Mr. Dr. Manishji.
Thank you very much, sir. I am very much impressed with your talk and whole talk I have heard. It's a very wonderful, and majority of the things which you have expressed that is not present in the majority of the book, sir. So I am very much thankful to you for improving my vast and in increasing my knowledge, sir.
Yeah. You are most welcome to contact me on my website, as far as personally you can contact me. We can collaborate further.
Sir, there is one query. I have one question regarding this, sir. Mm-hmm. If you allow, then can I ask to you, sir?
Yes. Please.
Sir, you have explained about the various whatever the breeding improvements program in order to improve the production potential of the apple. Sir, I have one query, that is there any possibility of creating the disease resistance in the apple by doing any type of back cross method?
Yeah, our breeders, they are working on this, or this four hybrids, they are working, they are having the same, they are working for apple scab and all that. You can contact on our website for on our this email address. My breeders, they will explain you the complete system and all that. They are having a very well planned program for that. We can go for further discussion in length.
Okay, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Manish. Dr. Sanjay Kumar Dwivedi, he communicates, sir.
Yes.
Ashish Tiwari, he communicates.
Thank you, Dr. Dwivedi ji. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Femula Khan ji.
Vimal Pandey, great, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey. Thank you.
Dr. Anil Panwar, informative, innovative talk.
Thank you.
Dr. Manish, he commented very informative presentations around the global warming.
Thank you.
Narendra Kumar, nice, sir.
Thank you.
Veer Negi, very nice presentation, Dr. Singh.
Yeah, Veer Negi, I know. Thank you, Dr. Negi. Yes.
Basim Raja, very informative.
Thank you. He's my scientist. He's one of our pomologists who will respond in further discussions when we'll work on collaborative works.
Shoaib Kirmani, very nice talk.
Thank you.
Gaurav Swadesh Singh, good morning, sir. Thank you.
Good morning to all.
R.S. Yadav, good morning, sir.
Thank you, Yadav ji. Thank you.
Sunil Sharma, he is asking something, sir. You can read out, sir, this comment.
Dr. Sharma ji, there is a scope for further study on blueberry, blackberry, currant, and chestnuts. Chestnuts are already in temperate system; they are coming out. Particularly in case of blueberry, I will say that we have to manage the pH of the soil. Soil management and agronomical practices we have to little modify in the case of blueberry. We have to do some research work on blueberry. As far as this hazelnut and other berries, he has mentioned, there is a lot of scope for further improvement there, but good genotypes we are having.
Gaurav Sudesh Singh, informative talk.
Thank you.
Dr. Manish, he commented again. Thanks, Prabhat Channel and Dr. Sanjay Kumar Dwivedi, sir, for organizing such a beautiful, informative lecture for all for us. Thank you, Manish.
Thank you.
Brijman Singh, he commented. Thank you. Vijay Prasad. And our journal commented, very elaborative, informative, excellent talk. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. I'm thankful to your journal and your studio and your Hot Talk team also. They have given me the chance to speak on this aspect and share my views and get some good feedback so that we can go for future research where we can plan some improvement there.
Dr. Akhilesh Kumar, nice presentation, he commented, sir.
Thank you.
Dr. Abhishek Singh, he is asking something, sir.
Okay.
Which one is suitable for subtropical?
There are some subtropical in my slide also. I have given the name also. We are having some in subtropical climate. There are some varieties that are going further. Particularly Anna variety, they are propagating it. Some other varieties are also there. We are just working on this aspect. Dr. Saab can interact with us in elaborate, and we can make some elaborate work about the subtropicals. We are having something in mind to work on subtropical area where some of the varieties can be suited.
Mahendra Kumar Sharma, nice presentation, sir.
Thank you.
Dr. Manish again commenting, in very informative lecture on nutraceuticals value, generally these things not present in majority of books. Thank you, Manish.
Thank you.
This C.H. Yadav, he commented.
Thank you.
Kiran Kaur.
Yeah. Thank you, Dr. Kiran. Dr. Kiran, thank you. We are having a collaborative work on Cape Goose Worry also.
Sanjay Kumar Dubedi, excellent presentation with past update knowledge.
Thank you, Dr. Dubedi ji. Thank you.
Manish, hats off to you, sir, for doing wonderful presentation, having vast knowledge.
Thank you.
Naprem Singh Fruit Sign, nice presentation on nutritive and dietary properties of temperate fruits.
Yeah. Naprem Singh, thank you very much. Yes, we are in association. Yes, yeah.
Khalid Bhatt, he commented, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Khalid. Thank you, Sunil Sharma sahab. Dr. Sunil Sharma sahab, thank you very much.
Dr. Sandhya Gupta, he commented, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Sandhya, thank you, after a long time, yes, thank you very much.
One question is there, sir.
But in case of Bangalore climate, actually we are having our network program in Ooty, Kodaikanal areas. So our apples are coming out very nice there. Even some of the saffron we have introduced there, that is also coming out very nice there. But as far as pistachio is concerned, we have to work for that.
Sir, thank you a lot, sir, giving me such a wonderful talk, sir. Thank you a lot.
Thank you.
Audience, please send your queries, question to progressivehorticulture@gmail.com. Response of audience was tremendous with very encouraging remark. We are highly grateful, sir, you for sparing time and delivering such an important talk. Thank you, audience, for your active participation and support. Thank you all.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.